I am Anwar. I'm a computational scientist, and I specialize in high-accuracy methods, including quantum Monte Carlo and selected CI. And I basically help domain specialists solve their problems using HPC at the highest levels of accuracy to be able to be predictive in their research. The classical way of doing things, which would be you go to a lab and you have a bench and you try a material and you try to see how you can make the new cathode better, the new drug bind better to the disease that you're trying to fight. Or nowadays, instead of having to build it, you just simulate it on a computer. And at the end of the day, that gives you the ability to test multiple materials, many drugs, and go through a large number at a very, very limited cost compared to what you would have to pay if you were to do the experiment in a lab. We use quantum mechanics to be able to simulate how electrons interact between each other, because the whole universe, and this goes from how galaxies interact to how our DNA or two electrons interact, depends on these electronic interactions. The problem is that the electrons are at the same time a particle, a wave, and they are entangled, so we cannot just know how they're gonna interact between each other. And this is just with two electrons. So imagine when you have billions of them in large systems like galaxies. Obviously, we cannot simulate all these electrons interacting with each other because the computational power is going to be too expensive. So the scientists and chemists started thinking of approximations. So instead, for example, of thinking of each electron interacting with another electron, they started thinking of this type of approximations. One of them is to consider that an electron, instead of interacting with every one electron independently, it interacts with a cloud of the others. So now we have one object versus a larger object. And that's feasible. And this gave birth to density functional theory, DFT, which has been used since the 60s with the evolution of science and with the evolution of computers and the needs of our society. We need extremely more control and more accurate simulations and predictions. And unfortunately, that approximation that made DFT so usable and so common now is coming back to bite us because we lose some of the accuracy that is required. You need to be able to treat these interactions between one electron to another absolutely accurately. This is where the evolution of supercomputers come to the rescue. There are other techniques that supercomputers are allowing us to use, and such a method is, for example, quantum Monte Carlo. Quantum Monte Carlo is slightly different in a sense that instead of trying to be smart about solving the equation in a very nice, elegant way, quantum Monte Carlo uses brute force. It just generates millions and millions of solutions. Each solution is then just plugged in the equation and we see if it solves it or not. If not, we throw it. If it's good, we keep it. And we repeat the operation until we reach a convergence. And the value of this is that we have such a large supercomputers that we can just have one core or one node or one part of our computer solving it for one solution, and we can replicate this across the whole supercomputer. Doing so, we can reach accuracies that were never achieved before. The beauty of the work that I do at Argonne is that I am not a specialist in one field. I am a specialist in one method. And when you specialize in developing a method and making it fast enough to be able to run on these supercomputers, you start solving for all these fields. For a battery, solves it for these metal organic frameworks, but solves it also for DNA and drug design. So we are able to provide one tool that is developed for supercomputers that solves all these problems at the same time. We always look for new collaborations with domain specialists to be able to help you solve your very interesting problems with the methods that we develop. So if you have any additional questions, please do not hesitate to contact us.